Welcome everyone to another episode of Bridging Beijing. My name is Kara Megan Lewis. I am one of the directors of Bridge Projects, a contemporary art gallery located in Los Angeles. We are going to open the exhibition, A Composite Leviathan, on September 12th, 2020. This is an exhibition of 20 artists from Beijing and Shanghai, and it's curated by James Elaine. He's the founder of Telescope Gallery in Beijing and the former Hammer Museum curator. Leading up to the opening, we are interviewing each of the artists in the exhibition, and today's featured artist is Zhang Xinjun. Joining me to guide the conversation is the exhibition's curator of programming, Clover Zhou. Clover Shuisong Zhou is an art critic, art theologian, and visual artist. Her publications have been seen in Art Forum China, the Art Newspaper China, The Art World, Rondian, and Vision. Clover will now introduce today's featured artist.
Thanks for the introduction, Kara. Hi, everyone. I'm very happy to be here to introduce artist Zhang Xinjun. Zhang Xinjun was born in Zhengzhou, Henan, China. He currently lives and works in China. He received a BFA at Sichuan Fine Art Institute in 2005 and an MFA from the Central Academie of Fine Arts, Beijing in 2009. He has had solo exhibitions in Akademie, Schloss, Solitude, Stuttgart, Germany, and in Galerie Yang, Beijing, and Zhang Xinjun Telescope, Beijing, and his artworks have joined group exhibitions worldwide. Zhang Xinjun focuses on how common materials and objects of his everyday life relate to their typical surroundings. The relationships he highlights often involve references to general history and his own past. In his art, Zhang aims to nurture a space abstracted from time and integrating nonlinear fashion elements of childhood, motherhood, imagery, daily life, memory, living spaces, society, and the natural environment. Now let's start with one of your performance works, Drawer Feet. You apply elastic bands to two drawers and make them wearable like sandals. You put them on your feet and walk on a busy street. In some interviews, you explain that drawers are significant parts of furniture at home. Drawers contain household objects as well as family memories. In this performance, the drawers contain yourself. Your body moves with the drawers. It evokes some subtle combination of different feelings, such as nostalgia, endurance, and a sense of the intimate relationships between human beings and their belongings. Would you talk about what do you have in mind when you make this artwork?
最开始呢，我为什么要想到用抽屉呢？ 其实对我来说，可能这种经验更特殊一些吧，就是说，当很多人去联想到抽屉的时候，他可能会想到记忆。 会想到一些比较隐私的一些这样内容，但是对我来说，这种特殊性在哪儿呢？就是，因为这种抽屉呢，它有一个标准的一个样式，就是它一般是在这种有三个抽屉的这种桌子并列的三个一样的这种抽屉，或者是就是有两个抽屉，然后呢右边有一个柜子。 然后这种抽屉呢，它在我少年的时候，基本上是很普遍的，而且另外一个特殊性就是说，在我们中原地区，然后很多这种农村的这种房子呀，都是有三间一样大的屋子，然后呢，三个抽屉，还有呢，就是在我们这个80年代出生的人。 那时候就是有一个计划生育政策，所以呢，基本上家庭的成员也是三个， 所以对我来说，这种关系特别的奇妙，就是它是一种，是一种巧合。所以呢，我只是想把这个抽屉作为像这三个房间一样来对待，因为我们三个人，就是我们那个时候的很多这个家庭三个成员住在三间一样的屋子里面，然后他们使用的这个桌子是有三个抽屉的，所以我觉得这种关系特别的有意思。然后我就用了抽屉，成为一个意象，就是它就好比是这三个房间，或者说它是一个家庭的一个隐喻。所以呢，抽屉放在我的身上，它跟我的身体产生一种关联。在一个最基本的一个行走这个过程当中啊，它随着我的身体开始就是运动，身体就像它的一个就是身体和这个家庭或者是房间它们是成为一体的，就是像在移动这样一种意象，就是这样一个形象。所以我当时选择这种抽屉，而且呢这种很日常的这种物体，它跟一个人的身体产生一种直接的关联的时候，它会产生一种很陌生的一种感觉。所以这种东西我觉得是这些作品比较凸显的一些因素。而且行走啊是一个特别简单的一个身体的动作。对，就是身体和抽屉啊，它们成为一个结合体，它就是像你所介绍的那样，就是它关于就是人和它的一些所有物产生了这种很亲密的这种关系。但是它新的这样一个物体，它就是它又是一个运动的，当然这种运动是还是身体嘛，所以它只是从形态上改变了我，改变一个人，它介于他们之间。而且呢，在马路上，这种马路它也对我来说是一种城市，所以他们整体制造了一个意象，就是在城市的这样环境里面，家庭或者是一个住所在移动。
Our next work is called Drawer Man. It's like a further development of the previous artwork. It's visually more astonishing to me. Do you view this artwork as a form of sculpture made of your body and drawers, or do you see it as another performance?
对，对我来说，它其实就是一个雕塑，然后身体和这些物体刚才就像那个一对抽屉在脚上走路那样一样内容，它也是家庭或者是一个日常之物，然后跟身体整个结合的一个雕塑。对对，而且这个呢其实让我想到一个很美的一个这个人物啊，就是贝尔尼尼，他有个雕塑是阿波罗与达芙妮，就是达芙妮他慢慢的变成一棵树。然后呢，其实这个意象我觉得跟我从抽屉脚这个一个脚开始慢慢改变，然后慢慢变成全身，我觉得这个意象可以跟那个当时我看到那个雕塑的那个感觉比较接近，就是它在那一刻正在发生变化，然后是人变成另外一个东西，然后只不过在我的这个抽屉人里面的人变成一个像机器一样，或者盒子，或者说有很多房子，垒起来的这样一个新的一件雕塑。
It's so playful, and just so uncanny, but it's also very serious. And to hear about the history of the object brings another layer of meaning. And there's this obstacle that you're creating. For your act of walking. And I'm really curious about walking, the process of walking in your work. you've talked about the migration of people.
Mm-hmm.
But also, so sometimes walking feels like a pilgrimage in your work, and sometimes it feels more performative. So I'm curious mm-hmm. about the act of walking in your practice in general.
Mm. Mm. 我觉得行走就是一个人最基本的、最自然的一种行动。 就像流汗一样，或者是说这样的一种身体基本的一种反应。行走，我觉得是一个，就是人，就比如说生存，或者你存在这个，你在这个世界上面最基本的第一个行为，就是我们要行走。所以呢，我觉得它就是一个，甚至不用去考虑它是我的一个行为的一种动作。 所以我觉得一般上我会用这样的方式，但是我觉得一个特别普通的一个动作，它可以变成另外一个形式，我觉得这里面可能就是艺术家需要通过他的创造来形成的一个新的一个内容。 而且在一个特别日常的、特别普通的一件动作里面，或者说两种不同的，像物体和人身体，或者说一些基本的动作相加，它会产生一个新的东西，它会变得异于我们生活，异于我们的常识。嗯，Yeah, I love
the alchemy or the transformation that's happening here. And this piece definitely feels more performative than some of your other works. How has performance influenced other mediums that you work in? Whether it's in your studio and you're making the objects or in the fabrication of the pieces, how has this performative element influenced your other work?
因为行为我觉得对我来说，它可能是我的一个起点吧，因为我在最开始艺术实践当中，我可能也是非常强调就是。 你身体在这个作品之中，而不是说你身体和作品是分开的。所以呢，这种方式其实不管是我通过这种录像的方式记录行为录像，或者是照片的方式，或者是物体雕塑，我觉得它始终都会存在的一种方式。对，就是，而且身体。 它不仅包括你对空间的感知，然后你身体自身的这种，比如说物理反应或者生理反应，包括你的行动，我觉得它是一个系统，就是说你身体可以包含很多，它就像是一个通道一样，在这个通道里面，它也包含像热量，然后。 像汗水，或者是血液，就是很多这种东西，它似乎是通道里面一种流体，就是一种流淌的一种流动的一种物质，所以呢，这些其实都是身体所可以扩散出来的，一些元素，而且呢，我也会用这些元素在我的创作当中。 而且这个通道就是建立自己和外部的一种联系，所以在我这个去通过身体介入作品这种方式里面，其实还是我跟外部的这样一种关系，有时候这些作品可能会以一种长时间的一种劳动为基础，有时候呢可能会以一种 图像式的方式，比如说这个抽屉人，或者有时候会以一种身体作为一种，比如说 标尺或者是模具，像是我拿身体去挤压一些泥土做成的雕塑，就是它似乎可以成为我的一种工具。
It's a good segue, it's a good transition into this piece, which is the body is not present, but it is all about your body. So
that's right. So this work will be shown in our upcoming show, A Composite Leviathan. It's called Mine. I think the title is a great pun. So it makes soil and wheat straw to make small sculptures of different shapes. Your way of shaping them is very unique. Each of them are shaped according to part of your body, such as your armpit, your mouth, etc. What was your experience like when you made this work? And I believe you make more small sculptures than these. So what is your criteria by which you choose, you know, which one to feature in your final project?
就是我做这些雕塑的时候，我觉得比如说我就是一堆土，或者我就是离土很近，特别是当我就是比如说我咬这个土的时候，我觉得自己就是一块土，它可以成我的一个，它可以是我的身体，甚至是我的肌肉。然后我做了很多不同的地方，大部分的都是比较贴近于这个骨骼的地方，比如说在这个这个脖子的地方啊，或者是这个肩膀啊，还有脊柱啊这些地方，对，然后其他小的，对，我觉得就是还是可能是他的选择的一些地方我会选择一些，然后放在我的作品里面。
And this work is called Coal, which will also be shown in a composite Leviathan. You made a bunch of coal-like objects out of wood, simply using ink to paint them into the color of coal. It reminds me of a very primary function of art throughout art history, which is imitation. My question is, how did you decide on the materials that you use in this work? And how did you decide to make coal out of wood other than other materials? And what did you choose coal and wood and create such a connection in your art? How do wood, coal, and ink speak in your art?
我觉得有时候我选的一种材料啊，它是一种巧遇。这种巧遇是什么意思呢？就是它可以把你的经验里面的，或者说你记忆里面的，你的一些经验能够激活。就是比如说像这个煤，它是用钢笔水和木头。那这些经验它是怎么来的呢？就是像小时候写钢笔字的时候，然后那个钢笔水啊，老师会就是弄到这个手上中指的地方，就是握笔的这个地方，或者说这个钢笔水洒到这个课桌上，然后渗进这个木头里面，所以呢我就会有这样的一种这种经验，然后呢它自身这种味道我也其实记得很清楚，而且呢在我以前住过的一个房子外面呢，就是一堆煤，所以呢，我对这个煤的这种光线呢是非常非常熟悉的。所以当这三种东西碰在一起的话，我觉得那些东西它好像被激活了，当然它成为一个新的一个内容，就好比这个煤，它可能对我来说是一种热量，就像上面我也提到了身体很基本的一些东西。或者说这种热量它也可以成为一个外部的一种驱动，一种能量的一种驱动。比如说它可以作为燃料，它可以供暖，所以呢我觉得它是一种热量。它跟最早的这种钢笔水然后木头它的经验是 完全不同的，它是一种新的一种内容。
And I know from when we did the interview questions for the catalog, we learned that you've been influenced by Arte Povera, the movement in the 1960s that began in Italy, that where artists turned to everyday materials to make their art. And in answering the question, you stated that the movement Arte Povera shows you the power of equality. And so I was wondering if you could talk to us about the notion of equality in your materials, in your work.
因为我觉得就是它确实非常非常的普通，不管是它是木头也好，还是钢笔水也好，它其实跟没我创造这个形象没有什么关系。但是即使我创造出了一个眉，它其实也我觉得是一个很基本的一种东西啊，我们需要的一种东西。它当然随着这个时间，随着这个政策呀，这种东西可能慢慢的会改变，或者说你这些东西它可能会去改变吧，就是它不再是你所认为的那种样子。然后我觉得我从贫穷里面，贫穷艺术里面看到了很多，这种力量，就是，非常朴素的，然后，就是一种平等吧。我觉得任何的材料都可以成为一种，成为艺术。任何的材料，它其实都可以超越它自身的，我们对它一种认识。
Next, artwork, a hole, a space, an organ. This is a work that you made for your solo exhibition at Telescope in 2014. You sew pieces of sleeping bags together into the shape of a cave. It is so large that a person of normal height can walk in. It gives the audience like a sense of intimacy. And it allows us to imagine the returning to the womb. Would you talk more about what inspired you when you made this artwork?
我当时其实就是觉得我想把房间改变成一个就是还跟人有关系吧，或者说它像是一个人的一个器官。当然我可能会想到比如说像胃啊，或者是一些其他一种器官，或者肚子。当我们进入这个房间里面，其实就是它是另外一种质感。其实也是想把房间变成一种人。然后呢，它的外部呢又是通过这个木头啊和这种 PVC 管啊水管啊这种东西搭建起来的。对。
然后你刚刚说它的外部是由这些木头啊 PVC 管，
对，木头和 PVC 管这种搭建起来的，但是内部呢就是像一个内部的一个器官，或者我们进入一个山洞一样这种东西。
你想制造一种对比吗？在这里面
我觉得是就是像对，可以说是一种对比，然后从质感呢，从色彩上面，然后这种这种对比呢会给你带来一种新的一种感受，好比是回到了一个地方，回到了像山洞啊或者一个比较原始的地方，这种原始更多是来自身体的这种感知。
At first when I saw the title, I wasn't thinking of an organ as in the body. I was actually thinking of an instrumentAnd I think that's because of, it feels like stained glass windows to
me.
And this kind of like safe space. I mean, the contrast between the outside and the inside is so different. And it's very surprising because you wouldn't think that this structure on the outside would have such a wondrous, you know, kaleidoscope or colorful interior.So it's a good, I don't know if you intended for that kind of,
kind of, 因为有一些人, yeah. 有一些人他会把自己的这种经验带进去，所以我觉得他其实就是人跟人之间这种沟通。当我想这种内容的时候，我其实并没有主动的去想，因为它并不来自于我的经验。比如说他提到像这种进入教堂，或者说这个 organ 就像是那个乐器一样的，就是管风琴，所以这些东西让他产生那样的一种联想。但是对我来说，我更多的还是在于空间内部和外部，然后空间这种质感，它跟身体的关系。
It's beautiful. I wish we could go inside.
Yeah, I did. The first time.
You did?
The first time I met Xinjun. Yeah.
Aha.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Wow.
That is right. 6 years ago. Oh my.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was a. I definitely felt the contrast. The contrast of, you know, your expectation and what you feel inside.
对，而且那个洞我觉得其实就是它给你的一个这样的，就是因为有一种仪式感，你要进入一个地方，你必须要就是，它不是说很通常的一种方式你就可以进入了，所以它带来一种就是这种仪式感，我觉得就是像你进入一个山洞。
Yeah, it's kind of like when you entering a cave, it somehow has a sense of ritual. You just suddenly calm down and, you know, be in a different state.
Yeah, something that is inherent, it's innate in all of us, you know, we're born with that.
Coming to our exciting brain hole. So the previous work, a hole, a space, an organ, was your first attempt to create an installation composed of triangular pieces. And later on, you made a couple of similarly shaped installations, including this one, brain hole. Which will also be presented in a composite Leviathan. Unlike your previous work, the shape of green hole is based on the shape of a wormhole, in a piece of wood. You scale the size of the wormhole up to human size, and you change the material from sleeping bags to green canvases. And these are common materials around the construction sites and temporary markets of rural migrant workers and peddlers in China. So I just wonder, is there any connection between the materials and the wormhole in your artwork?
其实这件作品呢，材料，它跟这个虫洞并没有直接的关系。我觉得就是也是一组比较矛盾的吧，它这种关系也是一种矛盾关系，就是这种材料，这种绿帆布啊，它就是出现在这种临时市场啊，或者说它会让我们想到军用帐篷这样一种材料，所以它始终会有一种紧急情况，应对紧急情况这样一种提示作用，就是好像我们随时都可以去答应扎寨，就是非常临时，非常，很可以迅速做出反应的这样一种提示。但是虫洞呢，就是它是一个比较隐蔽的，而且是一个微观的一个世界。当我看到这个虫洞的时候，就是这个虫窟窿的时候，我就想，对于这个虫来说，这个其实它的一个非常很奇妙一种建筑啊，里面的这种各种穿梭的这种孔洞啊，特别的奇妙。所以呢，我觉得一种是，像你随时可以去撤退，随时可以去转移这样一种状态，和一个隐蔽的，然后很安全的这样一种形态，它之间是一种矛盾。 也不是就是一个长久的一种状态，它其实就是一个比较隐蔽的，一种微观的一种状态。
It is more, it's not like eternal, but to me it's more about being hidden. Being hidden
安全
and being safe.
不是说用材料直接的，就是直接用材料像去分析，然后呢去进入到它最终的那个终点，而是通过对比，然后呢它会产生一个新的一个意义，或者说新的内容。
I only have one last question, but actually I think Xinjun said something before regarding your childhood memory, because you grew up in the countryside, and your experiences and memory really contribute a lot to your art practice. If you'd like to talk something about it.
我觉得它其实并不是我特别重要的一部分了，但是呢它对我来说是一种办法，就是当我去通过这些经验，通过不同的经验，他们去相遇，或者说去叠加，然后组合，去碰撞啊，这些我觉得，它只是一种办法。你可以说它这东西来自于我的记忆，或者说我在少年时期这种生活的经验。但是它确实能够帮助我，比如说在城市，我能够，一个定位吧，我觉得是一个定位，因为我觉得要去适应这个环境，我首先可能要知道我在一个什么位置，然后对我来说，我觉得这是一个办法，是，就比如说我可能更愿意行走，因为行走它比开着汽车，我觉得更接近于我的经验，我觉得它不仅来自于我的记忆，还有来自于我对环境的一种感知。这种环境它可能是异于现在我所处的这种环境，所以呢，它有一部分来自于我生长，来自于我的记忆。对。
Now I understand.
所以我觉得这种东西在我。比如说行走的时候，我可能脑子里出现的并不是现在的这个地方，可能就是它出现是另外一种地方，它是一个新的环境。通过这种方式，我觉得就是我可以去找到我的位置。所以好像是这种记忆啊，这种东西是一种办法，让我能够在这个地方能够跟这个环境相处，它也是一种相处吧。然后走路其实只是一种比喻，它只是代表了我的一种办法，就是这种办法可能跟我的记忆，或者是我成长的环境，或者是我觉得这种方式更对它就更近一些。可能也包括其他的一些这种内容吧，不仅仅是走路。
I agree. We wish you could walk all the way to Los Angeles and be with us for the show.
Yes, that way the way maybe it's only possibility now.
Yeah. This has been so wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
We're so excited to be able to share your work in this exhibition and particularly this amazing green hole behind me. It's just going to be, I can't wait for the exhibition to open and for people to experience your work here in Los Angeles. I think they're going to connect with it very strongly. To everyone listening or watching, thank you for tuning in. And if you would like to learn more, please visit our website, bridgeprojects.com, where you can also get a copy of the, can you see it? Oh, goodness, there it is, the catalog, which is available for purchase on our shop. And we'll see everyone next time.
Yay. That's the end of the recording.
That's it. Yeah. That was just great. Mm-hmm.